In 2012, America's on-again, off-again love affair with Formula One finally seemed to settle down with the completion of this wonderful racing facility here in Texas. Since then, we've been treated to some incredible races, including, of course, that classic wet-dry championship decider of 2015. It's the Circuit of the Americas then, situated 14 miles outside the great city of Austin. This is the 3.6-mile lap with 20 corners, 10 each to the left and to the right, and top speeds of around 200 miles per hour. Overtaking opportunities are available into turns 1 and 12, especially with that rear wing DRS wide open. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Williams. They've had one retirement in the last five races. What do you think that says about the reliability of their car?
It's a good statistic for sure, as it demonstrates not only mechanical reliability, but consistency from both drivers as well. These are two of the first boxes you have to tick for any successful season.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Kimi Raikkonen's perfect lap yesterday sees him start from pole position, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Hülkenberg, Sergio Perez, and Leclerc, and McLaren, Stroll, Magnussen, and Carlos Sainz, Ocon, Hamilton, Max Verstappen, and Alonso, Sirotkin, Bottas, Pierre Gasly, and Marcus Ericsson. Hartley and Roman Grosjean starts from the back of the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, you can brake late into one because of the incline. It's a slow corner though, so make sure you stay out of trouble. Good luck.
Thank you.
the super softs. Virtual safety car, reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Confirmed. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. We're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. Okay, clear. Box, we're coming in this lap. The gap to the car ahead is 3.1 seconds. Now, please, box this lap. Stop. No more scheduled pit stops. is 12.3 seconds. Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. Fernando's in for his stop. Gap ahead is 6.4 seconds. that front wing, it'll... ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. Gap to car in front is 12.6 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Plus 1 lap of extra fuel. Fuel target, plus 1. happened. Let me know you're okay. Take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. There's 3 laps of fuel. The car ahead is 19.1 seconds. Expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now. This is your final lap of the race. There's only 1 lap of fuel remaining. up rubber and bring it home.
Well, what a drive that was to take the win for Ferrari today. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
And as we can see, it's time for the podium, and as the drivers make their way out, there's a familiar red suit making its way to the top step. Fantastic win for Ferrari. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Well, the lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Look at where Roman Grosjean finished compared to where he started. That's a really strong performance, so driver of the day has to go to him, I think.
Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling instalment of this Formula One season.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. We all underestimated you, didn't we? You had a bit of contact today. Who was at fault there? There was quite a lot of contact today, wasn't there? Appreciate your time.